Ever wanted to make happy hardcore with a games console? Well, now you can. I'm Kutski, and this is my review of Korg Gadget for Nintendo Switch. Get ready! It's never been easier to get into music production than it is today with software such as Ableton Live, FL Studio. It's possible to create just about any sound you could possibly imagine. But for me, here's where the problem lies. I've lost count of the times that I've opened up a new project and stared blankly at the screen as the mind boggles with literally infinite possibilities. They say limitation breeds creativity, and I definitely think there's something to this. Korg Gadget for Nintendo Switch is a complete sandbox production environment featuring 16 virtual synths, or gadgets as they're referred to, ranging from leads to basses to drum machines, many of which pay homage to iconic boxes from yesteryear in both sounds and looks. The most notable gadgets for me were the Chicago, an instantly recognisable 303, the Dublin, for those rich Moog mono basses, and a sample-based synth, the Marseille, which is clearly a Nexus clone, featuring many classic sounds, including the M1 house piano preset, which is the definitive classic house and rave piano. The London PCM drum machine comes loaded with presets to emulate all the classics like the Roland 808 and 909, and a plethora of sampled kits for just about every genre of music you could wish to create. There are even some great experimental gadgets like the Kingston, a subtractive synth optimised for the classic 8-bit or chiptune sound, and the Kamata, which is a wavetable synth based on Namco's custom 30 sound chip, which was used in all the classic Namco arcade games of the 80s. So you've clearly got a diverse palette of sounds to work with, but how do we go about arranging them? The sequencer is more like a classic hardware sequencer than a linear sequencer you may be familiar with the likes of Logic or Cubase. It's almost a hybrid between Ableton Live's Session View and a classic tracker, if you're old enough to remember those. So your workflow is to choose a gadget, add it to the project, select the empty pattern in the first scene, draw in your notation in the piano roll, and then add a new scene to create more parts with the same instrument, and add more gadget instruments to build your track. You have to be realistic with the expectations of what you're going to be able to create with the software. It's not supposed to be a rival to any of the previously mentioned doors, but it is certainly more than a toy or a curiosity. It's possible to make some really impressive compositions across a huge variety of genres, and I genuinely had fun working with the limitations of the interface. The interface is the one part that I did struggle with at first. With the Switch's relatively small touchscreen and obvious lack of mouse and keyboard, I found myself working with a controller most of the time, which felt a little cumbersome at first. But once I got used to the shortcuts, some of the tricks, such as altering parameters by tilting the controller with motion controls, started flying through the menus. It also has to be noted that Korg Gadget is available on PC, Mac, tablets, phones, all of which I understand offer some more robust features for exporting and sharing your projects and easier navigation interfaces. But for me, the appeal of this software was the detachment from my studio setup. If I'm writing music in the studio, I'll just use my conventional setup, but if I'm chilling on the sofa and I get that creative itch during a game of Mario Odyssey, being able to flip to the Korg Gadget app and have a little bit of fun is a creatively satisfying experience. And this can be seen by the amount of hours that I've spent with the app so far. I'd be a little hesitant to recommend this app to a complete beginner. There is a tutorial in the app to get you started, but Korg Gadget does follow a lot of professional production conventions, which might not be instantly intuitive. But if you're prepared to invest some time, watch a few videos on YouTube, I think most people are going to get some value and enjoyment out of the app. In summary, I really enjoyed my time with Korg Gadget. Even after fairly long breaks from the app, I kept finding myself coming back to it to scratch that creative itch, more so than any other game that I have installed. Depending on your attachment to games consoles, you may have a better experience on other platforms like an iPad, say, but either way, I would highly recommend checking out Korg Gadget. Hope you enjoyed this review. This is my new gaming channel for video game content, so please consider hitting the subscribe button if you're new here. If you would like to get more content like this, please like the video and let me know in the comments if you know of any other bizarre music creation tools which you might have used in the past. And until next time, this is Kutski signing out. Keep the game alive.